Hello folks, today we're going to be playing on the Mallaig extension of the West Highland Railway. This was opened in 1901 and operated by the North British Railway. Of course, it was all paid for by the British government, England in other words, and it has been ever since. It became part of the London North Eastern Railway in the groupings of 1923 and British Railways at nationalisation. The steam services on British Rail were destroyed in the British Rail Modernisation Plan of 1967, which took steam trains off this line. By 1984, somebody in Whitehall or somewhere opened an eyeball and noticed that a lot of the little bits of rail that they'd sold off to preservation groups were actually making quite a bit of money running steam trains over these unprofitable sections. Oh dear! And a worm turned in their mind. So they put a steam choo-choo on, see what happened. And this was 1984, as I said. And they suddenly found out they got tourists. So they called this the West Highlander. Ran for several years, latterly called the Lochaber. Following the privatisation in 1995, this was taken over by West Coast Railway Company. They're a leasing company, basically, of historical stuff. They began operating it as the Jacobite. And it's been going quite happily ever since, and now there's two of them at it. Two choo-choos, that is. So we're going to be going and having a play on this. As an aside for the Harry Potter fans who may have landed here, not a lot of this is about Harry Potter. You will see a little bit of the train going up the side of Loch Eel, like the Harry Potter train. A very beautiful loch. I love going up the side of it when I can, and the Glenfinnan Viaduct, which there's lots of viaducts rather similar in the UK one way or another, and this one's not particularly a large one and not particularly old, being 1901 like the rest of the railway. So they also are a little bit purist. They'd notice that Loch Eel is West Coast. The station in London, King's Cross, is on the old LNER road, which is East Coast Main Line. Caught me out, to be honest. But looking at the history, all these lines up in the north of Scotland, and this one included, were handed over to the LNER at the rationalisation of 1923. So it's actually quite correct. Otherwise, the station that the Hogwarts Express supposedly finishes at in Scotland is in fact Gotland's station, which is in the North Yorkshire Moors, on the North Yorkshire Moors Railway, which was LNER in its day. That's also a very lovely little railway, maybe better than this. And of course, may be found as a separate video on this channel, which I hope you join. Finally, we have arrived at Fort William, courtesy of the most excellent and recommendable Lochs and Glens Holidays, where we have been booked onto the train and slowly get marshalled thereinto as a complete group. But not actually before we check out the loco that's going to be dragging us, which turns out to be a K1 class locomotive, number 6205, called Lord of the Isles, which was knocked together by North British in 1947. Let's get on and get on with it. We'll be right back. which point loads of oldies disturbed themselves out of their slumbers with their mobile phones akimbo and descended on us. They were not to be outdone in getting their little pictures. No way. What a scramble. There's no way I could get back until the train was well underway. Oh well.
Thank you.
And so with that cast iron squeal, we end up in Mallaig, at the end of the line. Hope you enjoyed this little one. We'll perhaps have a look at some more of our stuff, either on the website or on the YouTube channel.